BitTorrent has several steps for publishing. First, a peer creates what's called a torrent, which contains metadata about the tracker and all of the pieces of the file in question, as well as a checksum for each piece of the file at the time the torrent was created. Now, some peers in the network need to maintain a complete initial copy of the file. Those peers are called seeders. Now, to download a file, a client first contacts the tracker, which provides this metadata about the file, including a list of seeders that contain an initial copy of the file. Next, the client starts to download parts of the file from the seeder. Once the client starts to accumulate some initial chunks, hopefully those chunks are different than those that other clients in the network that are also trading the file have. At this point, clients can begin to swap chunks. As clients begin swapping distinct chunks with one another, the idea is that eventually, after enough swapping, everyone gets a copy of the complete file. Clients that contain incomplete copies of the file are called leechers. The tracker allows peers to find each other, and it also returns a random list of peers that any particular leecher can use to swap chunks of the file. Previous peer-to-peer file sharing systems used similar swapping techniques, but a problem that many of them faced and which BitTorrent solved is called freeloading, whereby a client might leave the network as soon as it finished downloading a copy of the file, not providing any benefit to other clients who also want the file.